Well, Lions fans, the Lions are hosting the NCAA South Regional this weekend. And with here, head coach Rick Odette, not just head coach, but coach of the year in the Sunshine State Conference. Coach, to start off with that, what was your reaction when you found out, and what does that mean to you?
Well, I think any coach in those situations, obviously, you're appreciative, but I think everybody that has any sense in this business realizes that we haven't thrown a pitch or swung a bat or made a play or worked at the level they have. So I think any time that you get one of those type of honors, you share it with so many people. And, of course, the players start that conversation and then the staff and support staff and so on. So, no, it was great. I didn't have any idea. It was during practice, I guess, when it was announced, with the guys, I should say, and then at the end I got some water poured on me, so they surprised me for sure.
Now the Lions in the South Regional, that was your goal at the beginning of the year, and you're hosting throughout this roller coaster of a season. You're 35-15. Was there a point in the year where you realized, okay, it's not a surprise anymore that we're beating the top teams in the conference, that we can get to this point?
Yeah, I think, when we started early, we had a lot of new guys. We're trying to figure out what our route's going to be and, what type of team we'll be as a whole. Are we going to be on the mound more defensive and throw a bunch of strikes, more offensive? Obviously, we've done a really good job with the bats, but I think our pitchers have done an exceptional job to go along with our defense. So we've kind of got all cylinders. We're pretty confident with that for sure. I think that the turning point for me where it kind of, that we were real, I think was probably after the Rollins series, which was a great club that came in and, Buck Anderson hits a 3-run homer to win it, against them on Saturday night. So that was a great piece. But I think that was kind of the turning point that these guys started really believing they can play at this level.
All right, here with junior outfielder Bobby Sparling, the SSC Player of the Year. And Bobby made it to the postseason. First off, though, Player of the Year. What was your reaction when you found out, and what does that mean to you?
I mean, it's a really cool honor. My journey to coming to St. Leo, it's a bit unorthodox, to say the least. I never really expected to be in this place a few years ago, but I couldn't be happier being here with this team, this coaching staff, this school. The honor is great, but more importantly, I'm just really happy to be a part of this program.
Talk about the ride that the Lions have been on this year. You, as one of the leaders on the team, what has the brotherhood been like through this roller coaster of a season to get to hosting the South Regional?
Yeah, from day one, we set out our mission to win a national championship, and, this team bought in. Everybody's really been on board, and, it really is, like you said, a brotherhood. We all have a very tight-knit relationship together, so it's really been a great year. Yeah.
Now, the offense has obviously been one of the best in the conference, one of the best in the country, from Buck Anderson to Bobby Sparling, all the way down to Yo-Yo. Talk about the 1-9 hitters that you've been relying on this year and how special this lineup is.
It's I don't think there's a breather, in any of them. We've had a lot of moving parts in the lineup, so it hasn't just been the 1-9 same guys. We've had a lot of guys that have come in. I think a centerpiece, and it hasn't got as much recognition, is a guy like Sam Crail, who's played sore and played through a lot of injury, but brings a grit to us and a toughness to us that helps the other guys around, and Trovinger, and of course you have Bobby and Buck and Yo and Roa, Wyman. I mean, there's a lot of guys that we can talk and Eddie, of course, that we could talk. But I think the best thing about these guys is, like yesterday when guys were being announced, they were genuinely happy for each other, which I think is a special team when you have guys thinking that way.
Pitching staff, you found a core rotation with Beck, Frigio, Heidel, and then you go to the bullpen with Booth, Brzezinski, and the closer, Justin Jones. the pitching is your child, and you love the staff this year. Talk about them and how they've progressed to get to this point.
Yeah, as you said, I mean, it's, you know, we've had three guys and starters of Beck, Dariel, Braden Heidel that done a really good job, and some midweek guys that have filled in. Our bullpen, as you said, those guys have been, you know, very, very good, very reliable. But then you see through some guys in there like Luke Kishuda and guys like that, Nick Jennings, that done a really good job of filling some innings for us that we needed, and we know we're going to need this weekend as well. They've done a really good job. There wasn't a lot of experience when we came in with this group, so those guys were kind of learning, you know, by fire, basically. So they've done a really good job. Again, it's about attack and making sure that our guys can get themselves in good counts and throw their pitch and be who they are.
And you yourself, what has been the key to your success this season at the plate and in the outfield, being one of the best outfielders and hitters in the NCAA?
I mean, for me, honestly, you know, God's been really good. You know, I think my relationship with him more than anything has, you know, allowed me to excel. You know, he just blessed me with just being in this position and being on this team. And other than that, baseball's, you know, it's just baseball, just going out and playing. And, you know, I think just playing with, you know, without a burden and just playing free has been a key for me.
Lee, on Thursday, that's your first game. Talk about the Flames and how tough that game is going to be, what you have to do to get past them.
Well, I mean, they're technically the hottest team in the region. You know, they got hot for the tournament to get in, and Coach Brew, we've played him since I've been here a number of different times, and they're always well coached. Those guys are going to play with some toughness. They've got a good arm that's going to go up against us immediately. So we know that we better be ready. If we think we're just going to walk in and win, we're going to be disappointed, but I don't think our guys will let that happen.
And finally, hosting. I got the NCAA logo in the background on the video board. Getting the whole stadium ready here. Talk about how important that is for you and what goes into hosting the NCAA regional.
Well, I think it's people like you, right? Our staff, you see all the coaches involved. Obviously, the staff within the department here has been lights out. And, you know, we had some obstacles with some health on some staff members, and others have stepped up and has done a great job from top to bottom. So I think when you have that type of excitement and you can bring it to campus, especially, as far as I know, I don't think we've done this on the baseball side yet. You know, we've been used to doing this in a lot of other sports, but we're really proud of that. And we're proud for our alums, because there's a lot of teams that for whatever reason weren't able to do it, and we're able to you know, take this and hopefully they're proud of it, because we're proud to be part of them.
Well, St. Leo playing postseason baseball for the first time since 2001. Thanks, Coach, and good luck.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.